पेंडुलम हैज लेंथ 0.4 मीटर, लेंथ ऑफ पेंडुलम 0.4 मीटर एंड मैक्सिमम स्पीड 4 मीटर पर सेकंड. लेट v1 इज द मैक्सिमम स्पीड एंड इज 4 मीटर पर सेकंड. रिमेंबर ए पेंडुलम हैज अ मैक्सिमम स्पीड व्हेन इट इज एट इट्स मीन पोजिशन. When the length makes an angle of 30 degree with the horizontal, so angle made by length with horizontal is equal to angle made by length with horizontal is equal to 30 degree. Then its speed will be, means speed of pendulum when it is at that position. So look at the situation, it is quite simple example. So here is a simple pendulum, a bob of certain mass, and here is a string of length L. Now when pendulum is at its mean position, then it has only kinetic energy and its speed is maximum. When that pendulum is somewhere at position B, then it possesses both kinetic energy as well as potential energy. So here in the present problem, we were given the situation that the length of pendulum makes an angle of 30 degree with the horizontal. This is the horizontal and it makes an angle of 30 degree. So what is the angle made by length of pendulum with vertical? It is 60 degree. It is what? 60 degree. So see here, as far as the length of pendulum is concerned, this is length L, this is length of simple pendulum L, and we can resolve this L into two components. So one of the component is OP. So when L is resolved into two components, that component which makes an angle of theta, so it is L cos theta, it is what? L cos theta. And from the figure, what we can say? See here, when pendulum reaches to height h, this is the original position at mean position, and when pendulum is at a height h from the original position, then that pendulum has both kinetic energy as well as potential energy. And from the figure here, total length L is equal to L cos of theta plus the height to which that pendulum rises, or h is equal to L minus of L cos theta, or it is equal to L is taken as common 1 minus cos of theta. Theta here is 60 degree. Angle made by vertical with the length of pendulum is 60. So L in bracket 1 minus cos 60, and we know what is cos 60? Cos 60 is sin 30, means it is 1 by 2. So height h is found to be L into 1 by 2, but length of pendulum is given 0.4, so divided by 2, so height will become 0.2 meter. Now according to law of conservation of energy, energy at mean position, pendulum has only kinetic energy. So, as far as mean position A is concerned, the kinetic energy possessed by pendulum is half mv1 square, where v1 is the maximum speed and it is given as 4 meter per second. And when pendulum is at position B, means when pendulum rises to height h, no doubt it has a potential energy mgh. At the same time, if v2 is the velocity of pendulum at that position, then it has a kinetic energy half m into v2 square. And here we want to find out the value of v2. So m on both sides get cancelled. So v1, half v1 square, half multiply by 2. So we will get v1 square is equal to 2gh plus of v2 square. Here 2 get cancelled, here 2 get cancelled, and here 2 is multiplied. So therefore v2 square is equal to v1 square minus of 2gh. Value of v1 means maximum velocity, it was given as 4, so 4 square. minus 2 into g is given, it is 10 into height h is 0.2. We had calculated height h is equal to what? 0.2. So this is equal to 4 square means 16 minus of, here it is 2 into 0.2, 0.4 into 10 means it is 4. So this is equal to 12, or V2 is equal to under root of 12, means it is under root of 4 into 3. Square root of 4 means we can take it as 2 outside the square root. So it is 2 root 3, and unit is meter per second. So out of 4 option, option C, that is 2 root 3, is the correct option for this question.